Hello students and welcome back to the video lecture series of web programming. Today's topic is jQuery events. I am your instructor Ms. Shruti Rawal. So first thing that comes to your mind is what do you mean by event? Before studying the event methods in jQuery, what do you mean by event? All the different actions that a visitor performs on your web page can correspond or can be called as event. For example, your web page consists of a button. If the user is clicking on a button, that click is known as an event. So event represents the precise moment when something happens. So it is basically an occurrence of something. For example, moving your mouse, selecting a radio button, clicking on an element, losing the focus of the text box, getting the focus on the text box, pressing the key of the keyboard. These all are the events, or you can say normal events, that are interacted while you are viewing a web page. Now, whenever you are referring to the term event, we usually use the word fire. So event is normally fired. When we are telling that event is occurring, we tell it as event is fired. It means I am telling that key press event is fired, mouse click event is fired, right? So whenever you are going through the event terminology, you will hear this word fire. Now, if you are talking about events in jQuery, what are the different, or you can say common DOM elements? So basic mouse events, keyboard events, form events, and document events, these are the categories in which the events are divided. So you can see in this table which categories consist of which precise events. For example, mouse event consists of click, double click, mouse enter, mouse leave. Keyboard events consist of key press, key down, key up. Form event consists of submit, change, focus, blur. Document event consists of load, resize, scroll, unload. So these all are the events which you can handle while you are interacting using document object modeling. Now, how to use this event using jQuery syntax? I have told you that in jQuery, most of the DOM events have an equivalent jQuery method, because we know that there is a DOM event, and if I want to manipulate that DOM event, I should have a method in jQuery which is corresponding to that particular DOM event. For example, mouse click is a DOM event, but if I want to access that particular event using jQuery, I should have an equivalent jQuery method which actually refers to the mouse click. So it is a very good thing that in jQuery we have almost all the DOM events method, corresponding methods. So for example, if you want to access a mouse click, click is the method in jQuery that you can use. Now, the most important thing after recognizing what event you are using is you must recognize or you must analyze what should happen after event is fired. So basically you are passing function to an event. So this is a syntax. You have to first select the particular selector in your jQuery. So for example, I am selecting paragraph. It means all the paragraphs. What should happen to what thing I am actually specifying the event? I have to select something on the HTML document on which this event is fired. So paragraph in this example is the element on which I want my event to be fired. What is the event? I am using dot click. So click is the method that is being called, and what should happen for that? I am passing the whole function inside click, and whatever action you want to perform, for example, if you want to change the color of paragraph, if you want to give border to the paragraph, if you want that some text box is dynamically created inside the paragraph, if some text is embedded into the paragraph, some text is getting deleted from the paragraph, whatever thing you want to specify, all the actions goes over here, that is inside the function. Okay. Now, what are the common event methods? The first method that we have seen rigorously every time we are seeing the jQuery is document.ready method, right? It allows to execute a function when document is fully loaded. So that is when your HTML document gets loaded into your web browser, you call this method, that is ready event. The next is click. Now the click method basically attaches an event handler function to an HTML element. So it is not necessary that you are using this click method along with button. You can use this click method along with any HTML elements. You can use it with paragraph, you can use it with button, etc. So if you are taking this example, you can see over there that I have used my click method along with which selector? Paragraph selector. And inside the function, what have I done? I have written $this.hide. Hide, it means you have to your particular element will get disappeared from the web page. Which element will get disappeared, that also I have specified in the selector. And what is the selector? $this. I told you this refers to the current context. What is the current context that we have selected? Paragraph. So all the paragraphs will be selected and they will be hidden from your web page. Clear? The next common methods are double click, mouse enter, hover. So these are the common methods that we use. Let us see one program of this event method. So here you can see that I have one HTML web page. Inside the body I have some HTML elements. For example, I have a heading, I have some division, I have a second heading, I have second division. Inside that I have some unordered list, etc. Right? So let us run this and see how does it look, so that you can get an overview. So this is how my web page is looking. This is the first heading, this is the second division in which I have written something, then I have the second heading, then inside the division I have some list items. Okay, now let us study what are the events that I have fired on some of the HTML elements. So inside the script, the first thing that I have done is I have written document.ready function, and all the other events I have written inside this document.ready function. Okay, so what is the let us first of all comment this rest of the code so that you don't get confused. Okay, so what is the first code that I have written? The first code is for the click event. Okay, so what is the click event? On what I have applied the click event? Hash div 1. And you, if you remember, we have studied in the selector that if you use hash, it means you are referring to the ID attribute of some element. So hash div 1, it means div 1 must be the ID. So we have the first division and the ID of first division is div 1. So we are talking about this div. And what is the event that I have specified for the first division? Click. So dot click, and inside that I have passed one function. Inside that, what am I doing? I am basically changing the CSS of that particular div. Again, I am selecting hash div 1, that is, I am selecting this division, and dot CSS, it means I am using CSS method for changing the CSS property, which is the property background color specified in the first parameter. In the second parameter, I am specifying blue. It means I am specifying a blue color on click of the division. So when you will first load the HTML document, the color of this division will be the default color only, that is the black color font you will see. But as soon as I click on the division, the default color black will change to blue. Why? Because I have used the click event. So as soon as the event is fired, this function will be called, and inside the function I have changed my CSS of that division. Let us run this code and see. So here you can see that the color is normal color, and this is the CSS that I have applied, the static CSS properties I have applied. So it has this background color blue, pink. As soon as I go to this division and click on it, the background color of this division changes from pink to blue. Okay. So this was the first event that has occurred. Now the second event, let us see what is the second event. The second event is again for division 2. So here hash div 2, div 2 is the ID for second division. For that which event I have fired mouse over. It means when I take my mouse over that division, these particular event will be fired and the function will be called. Inside the function, I have changed the CSS property. Here I have changed the color property. Color property indicates font color. Okay, so the font color will be changed from black to purple of the division 2. Let us reload this and let us mouse over to the second division. So here if you can be able to see, the color has been changed from black to purple. Okay, now let us learn the next event. So here the next event is DBL click, that is double click. So that is applied for the first division. What happens when I double click on the first division? Its background color gets changed and background color is becoming green. So let us try, let us reload this code, and if this is the division 1, if I double click on it, wait a second, sorry, this is an error. Now let us reload this. I double click on it, what happens? It becomes green for fraction of second. Okay, and the last is mouse live. So for what mouse live I am calling? The selector is UL and inside that LI. So here you can see inside this division I have UL and inside that LI. So I am telling that when you leave the mouse, so first you have to go through that particular element and then you have to go out from that particular element using your mouse. That is known as a mouse leave event. So mouse leave event is called, and inside that I am changing the color. Sorry, I am not changing the color, I am giving border to the LI. So as soon as my mouse will leave that LI element, what will happen? Those LI will get border, that is 4px solid gray border. Let us reload the page and see whether I am getting border or not. So this is my second division. If you recall, I am taking the mouse over here and I am leaving the element. So as soon as I leave the element, you can see that every LI got this solid 4px gray border. Okay, so these all are the functions that you can, sorry, event methods that you can use. Another method is also there, context menu for right click, that you may use on your own. There is mouse enter also for mouse hover. Okay, so these are the events that you can use along with the jQuery selectors that we have learned. So first you have to select a particular HTML elements on which you want to fire the event, and then whatever event you want to fire, you can use any of the methods that are available in jQuery and fire the DOM events. Okay, so this was all about jQuery events, and this was all about today's lecture. Thank you.